Chiefs fans, make some noise and welcome to the cage, Carson, the perfect storm, Hardman!
He is the number two welterweight in the state of Utah, and tonight could be walking away with a championship belt. He is Carson Hardman, one of the heaviest hitters and most consistent fighters in the state. The 27-year-old making the walk for the first time since January of this year. Jason, Carson is one of Utah's most exciting fighters. What do you specifically like about him?
You know, I love Carson Hardman. What you see is what you get with Carson Hardman. There is no persona. He's not trying to fake to be somebody else. What you see is what you get with Carson Hardman. He doesn't talk a lot of trash. He's straightforward. He's all about business when he steps in the cage, and that's what I love about Carson Hardman.
Hardman's got a very notable win. One of the most impressive amongst his 10 in his pro career so far is Stephen Newell. He was a 9-1 pro at the time out of Ohio back in November of 2020, and he got a first-round KO victory over Stephen Newell. It goes to show Carson Hardman can do this with the best of them.
Yes, he can.
A lot of power. Both these guys have a lot of power. You know, you put a couple of firecrackers in some gloves, and usually it doesn't go the distance, right?
A couple of losses under the Hardman professional career so far. He's been submitted twice by Clay Collard and Steven Seiler. No shortage of talent there. A couple of fantastic fighters out of Utah, as well as a decision loss to Brian Thomas back in June of 2019.
Here we go.
Our main event here, William Dunkel versus Carson Hardman for the vacant FFC welterweight championship. Fight 10 of 10 ready to get underway here right now. We've got Tyler Tomlinson for the final time here tonight, ready to get this main event underway.
Tyler working overtime tonight, Blake.
He's putting all the reps in.
Last time Dunkel was here, a little controversy stoppage against Steve Sharp. Oh, he's standing right behind me. That was him.
Oh, that explains it.
That explains it.
Steve Sharp right behind us, a legend in terms of Utah MMA. Tons of fights under his belt.
Dunkel's hearing him, though.
A little birdie told me if Dunkel pulls out this win that we might see a Steve Sharp-Dunkel rematch.
They're going to run it back?
If.
Fascinating matchup there. Carson Hardman.
But let's get Carson Hardman in here first.
Versus Will Dunkel.
Yeah, tough task first.
Carson doesn't cut much weight either for this weight class. He's a natural 170. He's a big guy. Filled out a bit last night.
Hardman out of Excite MMA in Lehigh, Utah. Dunkel out of Team No Excuse.
These guys have been on each other's radar for a bit now.
A crash course towards each other. 10-3 for Hardman, 6-2 for Dunkel. Two of the best welterweights that we could get here in the Maverick Center tonight to headline our card. Hardman. Dunkel with the clean shot.
Big shots by Dunkel.
Dunkel going to town. Hardman with the potential heel hook here. And that's going to be it. Carson Hardman. What a turn of events here. Carson Hardman, what a quick audible there. Gets the heel hook and the win.
Wow.
Didn't we just say how Joel didn't swarm him and that's that could potentially be what won the fight for him? And on the flip side, we see the opposite, and that's how it can turn out.
Wow. How good have these co and main events been here tonight?
Wow.
11-3 for Carson Hardman. We got Steve Sharp here.
Steve Sharp.
Calling him out.
He's
potentially here. What an adjustment.
Wow.
In the thick of the storm. He's able to get his composure back, and he locks up a heel hook, and he finishes Dunkel.
Blake, that's Carson Hardman.
That's Carson Hardman.
To a T.
You know, his ears were probably screaming, just ringing, and able to have the forethought to roll into the heel hook. That was phenomenal.
How quick do you have to be to adjust to that so quickly?
Look at how surprised Zach looked.
He looked as good as knocked out.
I thought he was, especially when Dunkel was raining the shots down on him. I thought it was over.
I don't know if you could define it as come from behind because it was so rapid, but it's just about as good of a come from behind victory as you can find.
Well, you know, he was in a terrible spot and obviously hurt and somehow got the cobwebs cleared fast enough that he was able to transition.
And no one here in the Maverick Center was expecting such a turn of events so quickly. Here's Jackson Hoops.
Fierce fans, referee Tyler Tomlinson has called a stop to this contest at 54 seconds in the very first round, declaring the winner by submission to a heel hook and new professional welterweight champion, Carson the Perfect Stud Hardman.
Over here, Carson. Congratulations on a big win. I know you and Dunkel have been on kind of a crash course to fight. Did the fight go as you expected it to go? It looked like he rocked you a little bit. Tell us how the fight went for you.
Real quick.
Utah wants up! Woo! Yeah!
Hey, real quick before I answer your question, Jason, I want everyone to know respect to Dunkel. I'm not even kidding right now. No. I like Dunkel. I like Dunkel a lot. I have respect for him. You might disagree with his morals, but respect for him here in the ring.
Always love that about Carson. You're always a stand-up guy, always respectful.
I'm not always that either.
So let's talk about the fight a little bit. Got kind of rocked there a little bit. Ended up pulling out a submission. How'd it go?
Did not expect that. I've always had a heel hook on my bucket list, and I finally got it. The sad thing is it happened to, a pretty good guy.
So now you're the welterweight champion. What's next for you?
I always knew, mark my words, I will be UFC champion, but first I had to be the fierce champion tonight. I'm on my way, baby. On my way. The impossible is possible. I'm the most average motherfucker in this room. And I proved that some little white boy on a farm can do the impossible, and so can you. Go chase your damn dreams. Woo!
That's what we love about you, Carson. Is there anybody you want to give thanks to tonight?
My cornerman. Above every... My coach is right here behind me. Mark Balser. Brandon Smith, Brian Baker, and all my sponsors, E1, The Movement, Excite MMA, Operation Underground Railroad, The Jukester. You know, these are people that make it possible. If you think it's a one-man show, you're wrong. You got to have help. And I appreciate my family, my wife. You know, she just went under emergency surgery this week. I really appreciate her dealing with my bitch ass. So...
So now you're the champ. When are we going to see you back in the cage to defend this belt? And is there anybody you want to call out, or are you just going to let them fall how they come?
Tomorrow, you choose. I'm the champ, dude. You guys are the matchmakers. You tell me. I'll fight anyone. Let's go.
I'm sure we can make it happen. Everybody, give it up for your new Fierce Fighting Championship welterweight champ, Mr. Carson Hardman.